Hi students, so today we are going to learn how you will prepare an aqueous iodine solution. The aqueous iodine solution is also called as a Lugol solution. So for this preparation, the aim is to prepare and submit 10 ml of aqueous iodine solution. I will give in the master formula for 100 ml and you will do the working formula for 10 ml. For this preparation, what are the operators are required? The operators like a beaker, measuring cylinder, spatula, and the dispensing bottle container. So these are the things we require for the preparation of the aqueous iodine solution. And what are the chemicals are required? The chemicals like iodine 0.5 grams. Iodine 0.5 grams and potassium iodide 1 gram. So these are two chemicals and also water, distilled water. So these are the things we require for the preparation of the aqueous iodine solution or a Lugol's solution. So first of all, I would like to take a dry beaker. In this dry beaker, I am going to iodine is available as a granule form. Okay. So I am going to add in this iodine granules. These iodine granules I am adding to the beaker. Then I am taking the distilled water. Today I am going to preparing 10 ml. The half volume of the distilled water first I am going to add in. That means 5 ml of the distilled water. So then I am adding these iodine granules to the distilled water. I am going to add it. Then I will go continue the trituration and mixing process. Once all granules are going to dissolve, then after that I am adding the required quantity of potassium iodide. The required quantity of potassium iodide I am going to add in. So once you added potassium iodide towards the iodine, it is leads the polyiodide complexes. Okay. So, polyiodide complexes it will be forming. If I am adding a 1 molar or a 2 molar or a 3 molar, it is trying to lead to polyiodide complexes. So, because of that polyiodide complex, if you see the color change is observed. Okay, so these iodine granules are going to react with potassium iodide and it is forming the polyiodide complexes. Because of that, you are seeing that color. Then after mixing is properly is done, then the remaining volume I am taking the distilled water. So remaining is 10 ml, 5 ml is there. So that 5 ml of the distilled water I am once again taking. Then I am going to add in towards this aqueous iodine solution. So the complete mixing is done.
Mostly after adding potassium iodide towards the iodine, it will be forming a polyiodide complexes and it will be leads to that the color change you are observing, and remaining volume on the distilled water I am going to add it. So the remaining volume is 5 ml is there. So that 5 ml I am going to take into the measuring cylinder and I am going to add it towards the preparation. So after adding the distilled water, then mixing is done, then the product is ready to go for dispensing. So mostly this aqueous iodine solution or a Lugol solution, especially using the treatment of the goiter. So this is the dispensing bottle. In this dispensing bottle you will go for dispensing the product. So then you will fix the label. So the dose is mostly prescribing for this case 5 ml. Okay. So based on the treatment of goiter, mostly we are going to using the iodine deficiency supplement. It is one of the supplement for the iodine. Mostly in the treatment of the goiter, mostly we are going to using. Okay, this preparation, the caution is for internal use only. Okay. And the storage is stored in a well closed airtight container and keep the product in a cool and dry place. And the active ingredient is iodine and potassium iodide. So these are the active ingredients are mainly present. In this case, the distilled water is acts as a vehicle. So then you write the manufacture date, expiry date, batch number, license number and manufactured by. So this is the way. Once the product is ready, then I will go for dispensing this bottle and fixing the label. So finally you write the report. 10 ml of the aqueous iodine preparation is prepared. 10 ml of the aqueous iodine solution is prepared and submitted. So this is the way we are going to preparing the aqueous iodine solution. Thank you.